was rushing over to the exit door to see what was going on. They was making a lot of noise, and somebody sent a note, and it said there were 3 tractor trailers out there with food, water, and medicine, and mother started to really cry now. She really lost it now. And then somebody else sent another note, said there were 2 more tractor trailers that just showed up with dry clothes and pampers and all the other stuff that they needed. And mother just lost it. She just started hoo-hooing all over the place. And the young boy walked up to mother and said, "Mother, why are you crying now? You ought to be rejoicing. You ought to be shouting and rejoicing. Why are you crying now?" She said, "Son, once again, you don't understand." You know what she told him? She lifted up her hand. She said, "Thank you, thank you, thank you. Come on, y'all, help me here. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Anybody want to tell him thank you?" Yeah, what's his name? Jesus, Jesus. He's a strong tower. Jesus, Jesus. He's a shelter in a time. Be there when things go wrong, yeah. There's power in that name, yes it is. Thank you.
Oh, magnify him with me. Let's make him great, because he's greater than anything that we could fear, or any of our concerns, or any of our worries, because he is God. You're listening to Sunday Afternoon Praise with Cookie and
Mia
on your News Talk and Inspirational Station, WJSS 1330. And Mia, I have a bit of news that's going to take place on BET.
Oh, wow. What's that?
Coming up Tuesday, October 2nd, BET will premiere two new inspirational series. One will begin at 8 p.m. entitled The Best. Now, Sunday Best is a nationwide search for America's next great gospel singer, hosted by platinum-selling artist Kirk Franklin. BET's Sunday's Best will scour the country looking for the next best gospel singer in America. And superstars B.B. Winans and dynamic singing duo Mary Mary will judge the contestants each week while also nurturing the talented singers. The top five finalists will be coached by artists from the gospel and secular worlds as they strive to win the Sunday Best title. And they say that the winner will receive a recording contract, a Toyota Camry, as well as cash and prizes for their home church. That sounds interesting, doesn't it?
That sounds really exciting.
And I think I'm going to be tuning in to BET, and that's called Sunday's Best, beginning October the 2nd at 8 p.m. Also, BET will be featuring a program called Be Exalted, and this will hit airwaves at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And this is the BET's new original biography series, which will take a look into the complex lives of inspirational leaders from around the country. Some of these religious inspirational leaders are figures that lead out mega churches. Some advise the president, and some comfort the sick and destitute. The name of this program is called Exalted, and some of the people who will be interviewed will be people like Prophetess Juanita Bynum, Bishop Paul Morton, Bishop Carlton Pearson, and others. And that sounds very interesting. So we'll be able to take a look, you know, into their lives and what caused them to take the path that they did. And this seems that this is going to be very interesting. So we have something to look forward to coming up with BET starting Tuesday, October the 2nd at 8 p.m. We have Sunday's Best and Be Exalted. And I think we're going to have a wonderful time looking at these programs geared for our Christian audience. All right, coming up next, we have the Straight Gate Choir, The Holy One.
Come on, give it up for the Straight Gate Match!
Well, somebody come on and magnify him now. Give him some glory. Come on, just open your voice, open your mouth and magnify him. Oh yeah, he's worthy. He's a great I am. Come on, somebody, come on. Oh yes, he is. He's the Holy One. Oh, bless you. He is the King of Kings. The great I am. He's the Holy One. He is the King of Kings. Come on. Oh, he is.
to be. Yes, she is.
Question. Is there anything to fear?
I don't think there's anything to fear, but guess what?
What?
We have someone on the line who's going to tell us that.
All right, and I believe that we have with us today Elder Glen Edwards from the Berea Temple Seventh-day Adventist Church. Hello, Elder Edwards, and welcome to WJSS.
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. It's so good to have you with us today.
I am so glad for this privilege to talk to the people on the air.
Amen.
Because I love everybody just as Jesus loves everybody.
Amen.
And I have a good word for the people today, for the time that I have.
Thank you.
I urge them, first of all, that the request and prayers of intercession and thanksgiving be made for everyone. My God is faithful to me, He's faithful to you, and He is faithful to all mankind. And I need to let the people know today that the Spirit has prepared me, the prayer has shaped me,
yes.
The love surrounds me,
mm-hmm.
The faith prods me, the hope takes me, the Christ will meet me, and the same Christ that meets me will meet them as well.
Amen.
So right now, I don't have any problems.
That's right.
All I have are some challenges.
Amen.
That God is using to strengthen me.
Yes.
To help me.
Yes.
To develop me. To save me. To
yes.
bless me. To give me the victory.
Yes.
Because every day, in every way, I am getting better.
Yes.
I am getting better through Jesus Christ, my Lord.
Amen.
With nothing to lose.
That's right.
And everything to gain. I must trust God for a promise.
Yes.
I must try God for a miracle. I must prove God for a victory.
Yes.
And then I must praise God for a blessing.
Amen.
Because He is worthy.
Yes, He is.
He is worthy to be praised.
He is worthy to be
praised. I am so glad that I have this opportunity to share what God has given me and to share it with the other people in the air.
Well, Pastor Edwards, we thank you so much for those inspiring and encouraging words. And we don't have anything to fear with God on our side, do we, Elder Edwards?
No, we don't.
No, we don't. You know, in Psalms 27, verse 1, it says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" And we don't have to fear anyone, do we?
No, we don't.
No, we don't. Thank you so much, Elder Edwards. And would you give us closing prayer?
Yes.
Thank you.
May the peace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and rule and abide for all the hearers out there, all the receivers out there, and may the love of Jesus Christ rest with them until Jesus comes to gather them. This is my prayer in the name of Jesus and for His sake. Amen.
Amen.
God bless everybody.
God bless you, and thank you so much for calling in.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Have a good day.
You too.
Bye.
Bye-bye. And now for our WJSS listeners, once again, it's time for us to close out, but we just want to let you know that we love you, that we're praying for you, and that you can just walk in faith and that you can trust God because He's going to take care of you. And no matter what happens, just know that He has you in His loving arms and He is always going to keep you. He's going to keep you till the very end. Is there something you want to say, Maya?
Actually, all I wanted to tell our listeners is you're listening to WJSS 1330 Kingdom Radio, Haverty Grace, Maryland. And you know what? You need to stay tuned because coming up next, we have bananas.
Have a great week.
In the basement. He ran upstairs and he opened the door and the smoke and flames began to gush out. He shut the door back. Ran back down.
You've reached the King's Dominion with Kingdom Radio, WJSS 1330, Haverty Grace, Maryland.
USA Radio Network News, Don Henderson reporting. Secretary of Defense Robert Gates says the